وحدك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Brothers and sisters, your brother Muslih Khan. I come to you on behalf of PureMatrimony.com. This website is actually the largest Muslim matrimonial website in the world. So you can certainly go there if you're interested in getting married, you're interested in trying to find a spouse, or you're having difficulty finding a spouse, check out PureMatrimony.com. Not only do they have an outlet to help you find a spouse, there are also several videos and articles that are written about literally any marriage topic you can think of. So it's a fully packed website. Check it out, PureMatrimony.com. Today I want to talk to you about those of you who are struggling to find a spouse and give you at least some advice or guidance on how you can do that and make your life a little bit easier. Number one, if you're looking for marriage and you're having a tough time, the first thing that you need to do is to really ask yourself, why do you want to get married? What does marriage mean to you? Are you looking forward to a wedding day, or do you actually want to get married, settle down, have a family, and just be responsible for somebody else? Because marriage in and of itself is one of the greatest challenges for any human being on the face of this earth. It's one of the most difficult unification that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us in. So Allah Azza wa Jal gives us a few things to think about if you're looking for marriage. Number one, Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran in Surah Rum, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, and from His miracles. Allah is going to talk about marriage in this ayah, and He starts off the ayah by saying, by talking about miracles. Why? Because it's a miracle that two people can fall in love, that two hearts can come together. You could be on one side of the world, and your spouse or your future spouse could actually be on the completely other side of the world. Allah takes that individual's heart, your heart, and puts it together. That's a miracle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues in the same ayah, and He says, وَجَعْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً, and He has placed for you, meaning the both of you, husband and wife, مَوَدَّةً and rahma, love and mercy. Do you notice how it began? Allah says, وَجَعَلَ. جَعَلَ is past tense, referring to Allah, that He is the one that places love in that marriage. He's the one that places the mercy in that marriage. It's not you. So no matter what you do, no matter how hard you strive to find a spouse, at the end of the day, Allah puts love in the hearts for people. So that's part of the maturity, and that's actually the second piece of advice that I have for you. You want to find a spouse, ask yourself, number one, why do you want to get married? And number two, assess the level of maturity you have with respect to marriage. Why is it that you want to have a spouse? You want to look after somebody and settle down? This is a sign of maturity. You understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qadr, that you may or may not get married at the time you desire. That's a sign of maturity. You're responsible in terms of taking care of your own needs. You have a job. You're mature in that sense. You take care of your own expenses. That's a sign of maturity. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started off the hadith about marriage and said, "Man istata'a," whoever has the ability, whoever has the maturity. And scholars had differed what ability is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking about. Some of them have said financially. Others have said just simple maturity. Once you're mature enough, you understand, you're responsible, then marriage is for you. This is exceptionally important for the men, because the men, Allah called you qawwamun. Allah Azza wa Jal called you guys the one who is in charge of being responsible for your wives and looking after their needs. So that's really important. Here's the third piece of advice with respect to being single and looking for marriage. You want to start off by looking within your family. So by that I mean, go to your parents, go to cousins, go to aunts, go to uncles. Stay within the family nucleus and search for a spouse. So let your family and your parents, them, try to find somebody suitable for you. The reason why I begin with this is, quite honestly, no one knows you better than your family. No one understands your habits, your good ones and bad ones, better than your family. So they're going to be the most critical in terms of finding somebody they feel is suitable for you. At the end of the day, you can approve whoever they bring, but let them do the bringing. Let them find those individuals and present them to you. And the last and final piece of advice, insha'Allah ta'ala, to help you find a spouse is dua, dua, dua. ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless you with someone righteous. Pray the istikhara. Turn to Allah Azza wa Jal. Ask Him to give you the guidance. Ask Him to bless you with somebody. Brothers and sisters, wallahi, nothing will be given to us except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills it for us. And Allah says, Ud'uni astajib lakum. Call upon me and I will respond to you. And Allah never tells you what to call upon from Him. So use your imagination. Think about the things that you really want. And if marriage is one of those things, ask Allah, oh Allah, bless me with a spouse. Oh Allah, bless me with someone righteous. With these few points, inshaAllah, the single life will be much easier for you and your path towards finding somebody will be that much easier bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. If you want more information about this topic, check out a brand new fabulous website. It's called muslimmarriagecrisis.com. So muslimmarriagecrisis.com. Check it out, inshallah. There's actually a free booklet that you can download that talks about all of these things in more detail. So just imagine, go to the website, free booklet. It's all there for you, inshallah, and you can read about it further. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
PureMatrimony.com.